Today we are going to learn about the structure of the scapula bone. Scapula is a bone from the shoulder region, and this scapula is attached to the lateral wall of the thoracic cavity on either side of the thoracic cavity. Distally, it is attached to the proximal extremity of the humerus, where the head is there to form the shoulder girdle. It is placed obliquely downward and forward. Now we will separate this scapula, and separately when we look at the scapula, you will see that scapula is a flat type of bone. It means it is compressed from either side and it is triangular in shape. Now since we have called it flat because it has having two surfaces. Now we have not so far named these surfaces, but we can see two surfaces, one and second. We have termed it as it is triangular in shape, and therefore it should necessarily have got three borders and three angles. Now it's time to provide them name. So the surface, first we name the surfaces. There is one surface which is having this spine. That spine surface is termed as lateral because it is on the outer side of the thoracic cavity or the body. The other surface is not having any structure. That surface is attached with the thoracic cavity, and therefore that is termed as medial surface. Now about the border, there are three borders as I said. If you look at the thickness and the thinness of these borders, you will find that one of the border is thin, and that thin border is named as the cranial border, whereas thick border is called as the caudal border. The dorsal border, normally it carries the scapular cartilage above it. Then the angles, the angle formed by the dorsal border and the cranial border, that is called as cranial angle. The angle formed by the dorsal border and caudal border is called as caudal angle, and the angle formed by cranial border and caudal border is called as the ventral angle. Now we will in detail try to see the surfaces, borders and angles. Now first we'll start with the lateral surface. Look at the lateral surface, you will see that the lateral surface is characterized by presence of this spine, and this spine divides the lateral surface into two unequal parts. And if you look at the proportion, you will see that this is one part and this is about three times larger. Therefore, we will say that the lateral surface is characterized by presence of spine, which divides the lateral surface into two unequal parts in the proportion of 1:3. The spine starts from the dorsal border. This is dorsal border. From here it is starting and is running towards the ventral angle, where it ends into a pointed projection. This pointed projection is called as acromion process, and this acromion process gives origin to the deltoideus muscle. Now in the middle of the spine, you will see that there is a rough protruded structure, and that is called as the tubercle, and this tubercle is named as tuber spinae. The purpose of this tuber spinae is it gives insertion to the trapezius muscle, which is coming from the dorsal and the cranial and caudal portion of the neck and the thoracic cavity. Then the medial surface. Here you will see that the medial surface is characterized by presence of a depression. This depression is called as subscapular fossa, where it lodges one muscle which is named as subscapularis muscle. Now if you look at this subscapular fossa, you will see that the subscapular fossa is wide in the middle, and as you go towards the dorsal border, you will see that it is becoming narrow. And because it is becoming narrow, it forms two triangular areas at the corners. And these triangular areas, they are rough. And these triangular areas are termed as facies serrata. And why this name is? Because there is one muscle having the serrations is attached here. One is going here in the neck part, and the other is coming from the thoracic part and getting inserted on these facies serrata. So therefore This muscle is named as serratus ventralis muscle, having two parts, that is serratus ventralis cervicis and serratus ventralis thoracis. This is all about the surfaces. Now the borders. Now look at this border. This is cranial border. Cranial border is convex proximally, but as you go down towards the distal part, here it is becoming concave, and based on the thickness you will see that it is very thin. Now the caudal border is near about straight or maybe slightly concave, and it is thick. The dorsal border, although here you are not able to see any structure here, but in the living state it is always covered or attached by a scapular cartilage. This is about the borders. Now angles. This is cranial angle. This cranial angle is formed by the dorsal border and the cranial border. This is caudal angle, formed by the dorsal border and the caudal border. This one is the ventral angle, formed by the cranial border and the caudal border. Now look at the ventral angle. What structures are there? Here you are able to see this cavity. This cavity is named as glenoid cavity. And little above on one of the side, here there is a rough protruded structure. This rough protruded structure means tubercle. And this tubercle is named as tuber scapulae or supraglenoid tubercle. Now, this ventral angle, as I said, is having two structures, that is glenoid cavity and supraglenoid tubercle. Now, what is the description of the glenoid cavity? Glenoid cavity, we can define it as, it is circular, shallow, articular cavity which articulates with the head of the humerus. This is head of the humerus which articulates with this to form the shoulder joint. Now, cranially means on this side, little above the glenoid cavity, this is the level of glenoid cavity, above that there is a rough protruded area, and since it is little above, we are calling it supra. Supra means above, and this is a rough protruded area, means tubercle, and therefore it is named as supraglenoid tubercle, which gives origin to the biceps brachii muscle. Now, from the medial aspect means this is lateral part of the supraglenoid tubercle, this is cranial, and here from the medial side you can see there is a small projection. This projection is called as coracoid process. It gives origin to the coracobrachialis muscle.